Hi, biology friends. It's Sarah, your other biology professor. Let's talk about how to work problems dealing with paternity and crime scene analysis. Both of these applications make use of STRs, short tandem repeats. These are segments of repetitive DNA that are 2 to 7 base pairs long that get repeated over and over and over, like AAC, AAC, AAC. That'd be 3 repeats. Everybody has 2 copies of each STR locus, 1 inherited from each parent. If both copies have the same number of repeats, we'd say they have the same alleles, and that locus is homozygous. If you have 2 different repeat numbers at the 2 different loci, you're heterozygous, 2 different alleles. There's a lot of variation in the number of repeats, the number of alleles, so we can work with that. The chance that you'd share the same number of repeats at a given locus with any random person isn't huge, but by adding more and more loci to our analysis, we can get more specific and generate a DNA profile of an individual person. The laboratory techniques that you've likely learned about in your class for STR analysis are PCR and gel electrophoresis. I'm going to touch on each of these techniques very, very briefly here. So if you're feeling solid on those, feel free to skip ahead to the problem solving. Now again, I'm not going to go into a ton of detail, but I will link some of my favorite videos in the description in case you want a little bit more on each of these techniques. With PCR, we're going to make many, many, many copies of our target DNA of interest. We're going to do this basically like DNA replication in a tube, using a series of heating and cooling events in order to make copies of our target DNA region. We're going to make millions of copies of each STR from each of the individuals that we're sampling. So if we're doing paternity analysis, our sample DNA would come from the child, the mother, and any potential fathers. And if you're looking at a forensic analysis, your DNA samples would come from the crime scene, from any potential suspects, and from any victims. So we've done our PCR, we've got millions of copies of each STR locus that we're interested in from all of our DNA sample sets. How do we figure out how many STR repeats each individual has? Well, for that, we're going to use gel electrophoresis. Electrophoresis allows us to separate molecules based on size and on charge. So we make a gel that has tiny pores. You can think of it kind of like a very dense jello. And we load our samples into that gel and apply an electric current. DNA is negative, so it's going to move towards the positive end. Due to the gel's pores, smaller, shorter fragments are going to move more rapidly through the gel. They're going to move farther than longer fragments. So by separating out these STR alleles by size, we can generate a DNA profile for each individual, helping us to figure out paternity for a child or to see who was present at a particular crime scene. Let's work some problems. I'm going to disappear for a little bit so we can make the images bigger, but I'll be back at the end. The most common kinds of exam questions with this material tend to fall in 2 categories: forensics analysis and paternity testing. And you actually tackle these problems in slightly different ways, so we're going to work one of each. If you want to try them on your own first, go ahead and pause the video now. On the left, we have material taken from a crime scene, and we are comparing that with 3 potential suspects. This material could be any of a variety of bodily fluids, and we would have extracted DNA from this sample, amplified various STR loci through PCR, and performed our gel electrophoresis. And here's the result. Some students find the forensics analysis a little bit easier because in order to show that a suspect was at this crime scene, we are looking for an exact match between a suspect profile and material taken from that crime scene. Who's an exact match? Suspect number 3. If you're wondering what's going on with that
thicker band that you see in suspect number one, don't stress. It just indicates that there's more DNA in that band. It could be because the individual is homozygous for that particular allele, two copies of that allele, or it could indicate there are two bands there that are very close together, and we'd need to run our gel a little bit longer in order to separate them. All right, let's hop over to the paternity testing on the right. We've got a mother and a child and three potential fathers. Where this is different from forensics is that the STR loci, these alleles, they are inherited from the parents. So we're not looking for an exact match between the child and the father. The child inherits some of their alleles from their mother and some from their father. So any alleles they didn't inherit from their mother had to have come from the father. So alleles shared between mother and child aren't helpful here, so we'll ignore those. The other alleles in the child's profile we know had to have been inherited from the father, so we're looking for a potential father who shares all of those additional alleles. And the only one who does is number two. Now, of course, in reality, we'd be comparing many more loci in order to have more certainty about our suspects or our potential fathers, but this gives you a good idea of how the process works.
Drop me a like if you learned something about STR analysis. Subscribe for even more biology, check out my website for tutoring information, and I will see you next time.